What it is, guys, it's your boy King Mike D Games here coming at you with a quick little update video. Well, actually, it's a request that I got from my Instagram page. Someone wanted to see my PS4 collection, so I don't have that many. I'm at about 38 right now. I have about, I think, 5 or 6 games saved to the hard drive. I have all the Grand Theft Autos, like Grand Theft Auto 3, Vice City, San Andreas. I have, I believe, The Warriors, I have Bully, and I have Manhunt saved to the hard drive. So I have those on the hard drive, and I have these as physical copies. I have a total of 38. As you guys know, I'm more of an Xbox fan, but since I got the PS4 Pro, I've been playing it a little bit more because some of the games I've seen on the PS4 Pro does look way better than the original PS4. So as you guys know, I have 2 PS4 systems. I have this one right here, which I retired after I've been using the PS4 Pro, which is right there. Don't use it anymore. I use this one, PS4 Pro. And let's get right into it. First game I have here is Batman Arkham Knight. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. Haven't played it that much. Played it a little bit. Didn't really get into it that much. I don't know why. Just really didn't faze me. I don't know. It just really didn't do anything for me. So, but I played it a little bit. It looked amazing as far as like graphics go, but can't really comment on the gameplay because it was just okay to me. I played it a little bit. Second one I have here is Pure Pool. And actually, believe it or not, I play this game a lot. It looks amazing, and I'm a big fan of shooting pool, so it has a feel of a real like pool hall feel, and it's amazing. It's pretty cool. It's a chill, laid back game. You know, nothing too intense. It's something just you can just sit back, relax, and you know, pop in and just wanna just chill. So this is a real good game. I actually play it a lot. Pure Pool. Moving along, I have the Sleeping Dogs Definitive Edition. Haven't really played this game at all. You know, you guys let me know how this game is. I think I did play it. I played a little bit of this. They had like a little zombie mode, I believe, and I played that. And it was interesting. Didn't really get too much into it. The regular story mode. Guys let me know how this is. Let me know. Next game I have right here is The Order 1886. I like this game a lot. It was kind of short for me, but wish it could have been a little longer. But I actually enjoyed it. The graphics were amazing. The storyline was cool. Would have loved to see more. It's actually kind of like a movie to me. So, and I think Sony pulls that off a lot with a lot of their games. A lot of their games can be like made into movies, like Uncharted. It could be a movie. It would be pretty cool. So I really enjoyed The Order of 1886. Wish it was a little bit longer, but very good game to me. Next up, I have Star Wars Battlefront. I haven't played. I'm not sure if there's a story mode, but I did. Well, when I was playing on a PS on the PS4, I was playing this online. And it was pretty cool. Kind of like I want to call it a Call of Duty of Star Wars. But it looked amazing. It sounded amazing. It was pretty cool. No complaints. I would like to play this more. I might get into it a little bit more. If you guys played this, anybody who's watching this, let me know what you guys think about this and if it's cool or not. So, but it actually looked really amazing, though. I liked it, like, as far as looks goes, you know, and playing it online the little bit of time I did. It was okay. It kind of reminded me of, like, Battlefield 1. And you know what? I think DICE, if I'm not mistaken, did make Battlefield. So, yeah, good, like a Battlefield feel to me. Moving right along, Destiny. Destiny was cool to me. I have it for Xbox One. I beat this game on Xbox One. It kind of had like a Halo feel, of course, because Bungie has to do with it. And I liked it. I enjoyed it a lot. The other one, I think the new one, I really didn't get too much into the new one. But this one, I really enjoyed it. No complaints on this one at all right here. Moving along, Mighty Number 9. Have not played this game yet, believe it or not. I have not played it. I've heard some mixed reviews. I've heard that it's nothing like the Mega Man games, and it's pretty hard. I heard this game is pretty difficult as well. And I haven't really heard too much more about it, but I heard it was just very difficult. And the reason why I got it, because it was a cross-buy. It came with the digital copy for the PS4, and it also came with the digital copy for the Vita. So it's like basically you get your money's worth with this. I paid, I believe, like $15 for it. So for that much, I guess it's not that bad. But I'm definitely going to give this a try. Again, if you guys have played this, let me know what you guys think, what you feel about it. Leave it in the description below, the comment section below. And let me know about this one too. I told you guys, I really haven't played that many PS4 games, so sorry I don't have too much input for it. Apologize. Next game, Shadow of Mordor. I actually enjoy this game a lot. And actually, guys, for the PS4 Pro, when I played this for the PS4 Pro, when I put it in, it downloaded an extra patch, which made the game look even more better than what it did. I like games like this where it has like the Lord of the Rings feel. It's very interesting. Great story. It sounds amazing on my sound system. Really enjoyed this game a lot. Really enjoyed it. Would like to see another game like this. Maybe like a sequel or something. Really enjoyed this game. Haven't beat it yet. I'm getting up there. It's pretty difficult when you're fighting like the bigger trolls and you know, chief commanders. It gets really tough. But really enjoying this game right now at the moment. And moving right along, we have Tony Hawk Pro Skater 5. I've heard a lot of people didn't really like it too much. They say it was quirky. It wasn't, people say it's not fun, but I gotta tell people, with the first Tony Hawk that ever came out, it was quirky. It was different. It was not like a real skating game. It was more like, you know, like an arcade game, basically. You jump in, have a good time, have fun. Like, they had like the graffiti mode, I remember they had on there. I actually like this game. I have no complaints about it. I like the different skaters. Like, you can use like one of the Ninja Turtles. They had like Lil Wayne, Tyler the Creator, and some like other characters. And like I said, it stays true to the Tony Hawk franchise. I tell people, what more would you really want when you ask for when it comes to a Tony Hawk game? I mean, Tony Hawk games are meant to be fun. I really enjoyed it. So yeah, I think it's pretty cool. Next up. Oh wow, sorry about that. Things falling apart. Look, Ryu fell apart. That's all good. Next up, we got J-Stars versus Victory Plus. I played this game a little bit. Didn't get into it that much, only for the simple fact that the camera angles were terrible. Like, when you're fighting, it's all over the place. And it's very hard to stay, like, in the mix of the battle, because like the camera angles are not that good for this. That's all I can really say about this. The camera angles, it kind of sucked to me, and I couldn't get into it. So I played this a few times and I was done with it. So really can't give a full great review on this. It looked pretty cool for what it was, but I couldn't get into it. So that's what I think about this. Next up, we have Deadpool. This game, just like the movie, hilarious. A lot of punchlines, a lot of crude humor. I loved it. It didn't have the best graphics on it, but you know what? It stayed true to what Deadpool is, and that's a funny guy who's always cracking jokes and very humorous. So I really enjoyed it. It was a nice little beat 'em up, and I can't complain about it. It was okay to me. So a lot of people don't like it. I think it's pretty cool. Next up, we have Metro Redux. Haven't played this game. Have not played it. If you guys have played this, let me know. Let me know how it is. Let me know, should I play it? Or should I just pass it on by? Let me know. Next up, The King of Fighters. This is the new one that came out. I have the Steelbox case. I actually enjoyed this game. I'm a big fan of The King of Fighters, and this stays true to it. I heard a rumor, well, I think it's not a rumor, it's kind of true. In January, which will be in a couple of days, they're coming out with an update for this game to make it look even better. It showed like the screenshot of this version and the update that's about to come out, and it looks fantastic. It stays true to the original King of Fighters. You know, what more can I say about this? I mean, it's a classic. It stays true to the original King of Fighter games. That's it's pretty fun to me. So I enjoyed this game more than Street Fighter V, but I'll get into Street Fighter V in a little bit. Next up, I have Bloodborne. Bloodborne have not played yet. Have not played it. I'm going to jump into it. I heard this game is way better. Was a little more easier than Dark Souls 3. Oh, I just started playing Dark Souls 3 for the first time a couple days ago. And let me tell you, if you talk about a rage, that game is it's not for everybody. That game is utterly hard. It's very difficult. It's not for the weak of heart. you gotta have a good self control, because that game is very difficult and it's not easy at all. But this game I heard is a little more better, and it's a lot more cooler. So I'm definitely giving this a try out this week. I'll let you guys know how I feel about this. Moving right along, we got here. What's this? Alakin's gun. Haven't played this game. Have not played this game. Picked it up. It was a decent price. If anybody played this, again, let me know. Let me know how this game is. Should I give it a try? Is it cool? What's it about? Yeah, let me know. Let me know about this. Put this back. Moving along. Plants vs. Zombies. Garden Warfare. You know what? I like this game a lot. I like this game a lot because it's, I could say, it has like a kind of a Call of Duty feel, but just with plants and zombies. And it's not something you can take seriously. Like, a lot of people take Call of Duty serious. They like diehard fans. This is something you can just sit back, relax, and chill and play. I do have a part two. I saved it on my, I bought it for the on my hard drive from my Xbox One. Part two is more advanced. This is like pretty basic, but I like this one. It's basic. It's easy to play. Part two is a whole bunch of other stuff you had to get to learn, and I didn't really get into part two that much, but this one is a classic to me. I really like it a lot. Moving along, MLB The Show 14. Never played it, but one thing I can say about these MLB games, and they have always been consistent with, is the graphics. These games have always looked realistic to me. All the MLB games, from even when it was back in the day when they came out, they've always stayed true and always stayed consistent with graphics and how everyone looked and everything. As you can see there, that looks like the real deal. It looks like a real person right there. I don't know who that is. But again, if you guys have played any of the MLB games, let me know how they are. I've not really played a baseball game in years. This was just on sale, I believe, and I just picked it up just to add to the collection. So let me know about that one as well. Next up, Payday Crime Wave Edition. I'm going to be honest with you guys. Did not get into Payday that much. I played it for a little bit years ago. And I just didn't like the feel of it. It didn't feel like a real FPS game to me. It felt really clunky. It felt like a real mechanically. I mean, I don't know how to put it into words, but it just didn't feel like a real FPS to me. And I didn't really get into it. So, yeah, I mean, it sounded interesting when I first started playing it. I mean, the whole theme of, you know, rob banks, get paid, and everything like that. It's pretty cool, because I never really heard of a game that you really rob banks in, so it's different. But I really couldn't get into it. I just didn't like the way it moves and everything, so didn't really get into this that much. Moving along, Call of Duty Black Ops 3. I have this for my Xbox One as well. Great game. It was cool. You know, I had a lot of problems with the connection with this game. It kept saying, connection interrupted. And I've tried all the little methods. It worked for a little bit, then it went back to connection interrupted. I actually liked it. I like it a lot because I like how they brought some modern humor to it, like with the new dances that they had, like the modern dances that people do now, they put it into the game. So I liked how they stayed true to that. I like how games can stay in contact with reality and time like that. So I liked it a lot. I didn't like the supply drops. I mean, if you spent money, or even if you worked hard for it in the game, you very rarely got the guns or any of the special stuff. Yeah, it took like luck, really, or probably a lot of money, which I was not going to spend. So for that, I really didn't like it that much for that reason. But other than that, it was pretty cool. I liked it a lot. Moving along, Far Cry Primal. Now, be honest with you guys, I play like 10 minutes of this game, and it's not for me. I'm not going to lie. I played Far Cry, was it 4? I beat that. Loved it. Loved Far Cry 4. Loved the story mode. Liked the whole theme of it. But this one, it went a little bit too far back for me. What I mean by that was, I mean, Primal, yeah, you know, I don't know. It just didn't get into it. I just really couldn't get into it. It just went a little bit too far back into Man Cave style for me. And that's just my opinion, so... let me know what you think about this game and your thoughts about this too as well. Moving along, Killzone Shadowfall. Have not played this game. I haven't played this one either. Okay, so yeah, guys, let me know how this game is. Give me your opinions. Might have to give this a try too. Moving along, Overwatch Origins Edition. Love this game. It's a very fun game. Great FPS. Very interesting. I like how they keep this game updated. For Halloween, they had something special. For Christmas, they had something special. I like how games can stay in contact with the current times. I love that. And it keeps it really interesting. This is a game that can go on for years, and people will still play it because it's very fun. It's very colorful. And it stays in contact with the time. Very good game to me, is my opinion. A lot of people don't like it because Blizzard made it. I love it. I mean, it's different. It's a different game, and it stays in contact with what's going on. So that's cool to me. Moving along, Tomb Raider Definitive Edition. Big Lara Croft fan. I beat this game for the Xbox One. I also have it for it. Love this game. Love it, love it, love it. Graphics is cool. Storyline is always cool when it comes to Tomb Raider. And very intriguing. They always like how they restart bringing back Tomb Raider games, because like I tell people, it was one of the PlayStation's first, like one of their original lineups. They had a Tomb Raider game, they had a Spyro game, they had a Crash game. That's what the system was known for. So I like how they brought it back and remastered, and they have remastered editions too of the original ones. And this game was really fun. I liked it for Xbox One because you have the Kinect. You can say bow, you can say gun, and it'll switch out for you. And that's just another little feature it had for Xbox One. But love this game a lot. Really love it. Moving along, we have, not really gonna get into 2Ks. I mean, we know what it is. NBA 2K14, 2K16. You know, same old every year. I have 2K17 for the Xbox One. So I have that up there. It's the Kobe Bryant edition. And another reason why, I'm not going to lie, some of these games I got, guys, because I have a PS Vita. And I wanted to see how it would look on the Vita and how it would play. So, because sometimes you don't want to look at your screen. You want to look at, you know, you want to lay down, relax, and, you know, play a game, you know. So that's another reason why I got some of these games, is to play it on the Vita. So that's that. Moving along, we have Dying Light. Played this game for a few days. I need to jump back into it. I was enjoying myself with it. It's pretty interesting. So I'm going to hop back into this. I might do some live footage of it. It'll let you guys know. It'll notify you in your course of the comments. I mean, the notifications. It'll let you know when I'm online playing it. So, yeah, I'm going to play this week. So be on the lookout for this. Be on the lookout. Next up, I would have to say one of my favorite games of all time as far as now for the PS4. Uncharted 4 Thief's End. What can you say? All the Uncharted games, they all kind of remind me, like I said, of Tomb Raider. You know, you're finding lost artifacts. You're going through jungles. You're going through, you know, history. And it's like a history lesson with the fun game as well. When I played this for my original PS4, which is right over there, I showed you guys earlier, it was cool. But when, let me tell you, when I put this into the PS4 Pro, it downloaded the additional patch, and it looks amazing. Now, mind you guys, I don't have a 4K TV yet. So I know a lot of you guys saying, well, how can you see a difference? I have a regular 1080p Samsung TV. And let me tell you, when I hooked up the PS4 Pro, like I stated in my PS4 Pro versus my Xbox One S review, it looks amazing still. So I can only imagine when I get a real 4K TV. I'm looking to get a 4K curved TV. I'm not sure if you guys seen those or not. The little TVs that curve in like a movie screen. But I can only imagine how amazing it's going to look. I just got through beating this game about last week, and I loved it. The stories are always intriguing. Like I said, it can be a movie the way they write these games. So, love this game. One of my favorite games of all time right here. Moving along. Stick it to the man. Oh, yeah, stick it to the man. Never played this. Let me know, guys. Let me know what's up with this. Haven't played it at all. Moving along, Mega Man Legacy Collection. This game has the Mega Man 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. It's awesome. I like it a lot. It looks a lot better than, of course, the original. I also have like a Mega Man Collection. I believe I have it for PS2. Yeah, I have it for PS2 as well. This is just another cool game to add to the collection. If you're a Mega Man fan, because, you know, a lot of people... These Mega Man games are becoming hard to find in the wild as far as like for original Nintendo. Or if you do find it, it's super expensive. So, hey, this is another way for you can own the game. But when they come out with things like this, I will say it kills the value on the Nintendo games. Like when people make, when a lot of these cool games come out, like the Marvel vs. Capcoms that people love, it decreases the volume, I mean, the value of them when they keep releasing a lot of them. So, I mean, other than that, it's a cool game. I like it a lot. Moving on, Madden 15. Not going to lie, I think I said in one of my videos, I'm not a Madden fan. I've always been an NFL Blitz fan. Never have played this game. So, yeah, never played it. Graphics always, again, for the football games, I've always looked good, but just never been never been a Madden guy, so... That's that. Knack, never played. Let me know, guys. Let me know what's up with this. Never got into it. Tokiden Kiwami. Never played it. Never played it. If you guys have played this, let me know. Let me know what's up with this. Let me know if it's cool. Should I waste my time playing it? Because some of these games, you know, you get into it, it's like, dang, it's a waste of time. It's not even worth playing it. So, let me know. Destiny the Taken King. I honestly have, I don't know what this is. Somebody actually gave this to me. I think it's, I believe it's an expansion pack. Well, it says it includes Destiny, Expansion 1, Expansion 2, and Destiny the Taken King. So, I'm assuming it's the original Destiny game with the DLC. So, yeah, never got into this. And I'm, like I said, I like the Destiny game. So, yeah, I believe it's, oh yeah, so it's Destiny with DLC. Pretty cool. Next up, Killing Floor 2. I just got this game about last week. I'm actually enjoying it. It's different. I've been playing the single player mode. They don't really have a co-op where you can go online and play with people and like kill like these little monster zombie looking things. It's interesting. I mean, it's nothing too spectacular, but it's cool. It's a different type of game. Well, I can't say it's different because they have kind of like games like this out there, but it's a different spin on what we know as of a zombie game. So, and I like how they give you unlimited health. You just got to get away from the little monsters to use it, and you can, you know, reload your weapons, upgrade new weapons. So I like that a lot about this. So it's pretty cool. Moving along, before I get to this last game, which I don't want to call it a rant for Street Fighter V, but I'm going to get to it. Next up, we have two One Pieces games I have. I have Burning Blood. I just got this a couple days ago. And I have One Piece Pirate Warriors 3. Now, I know Burning Blood is the newer one, but honestly, guys, at this moment, I'm enjoying Pirate Warriors. It's very fun to me. It's an all-out brawl. You're basically taking over territories, you know, trying to become the Pirate King and have little side missions. I'm enjoying this game a lot more than I am with the Burning Blood. Now, Burning Blood looks amazing, as well as Pirate Warriors looks good. But you can tell this game has the touch on there where it looks super amazing. But I'm enjoying Pirate Warriors more. If you guys have played either one of these, let me know which one is your favorite. I like Pirate Warriors 3. That's my opinion. And last but not least, Street Fighter 5. As you can see, I dropped Ryu. He's in pieces right now. Look at that. He's in pieces. There you go. Okay, guys. Now let me get into this game. And let you guys know my thoughts. Now, when this game came out, I bought the collector's edition, as you can see here. It came with the statue of Ryu. Came with the game. Came with like some, with audio, like with some music or whatever for the game. But this is my problem. When they released this game was not complete. And what I mean by that is, you would think when you buy most of these collector's editions, you get DLC. You get DLC for the up and coming fighters that's going to come out. Kind of like when you bought Mortal Kombat X. It took a while, but they gave you the code where you can get the DLC. So when it come out, you're good to go. This game just now releasing the DLC for fighters and some of the skins and some of the colors, different wardrobes. And I'm like, why do I have to pay for it? I paid $100 for this game and I have to pay for a DLC. And I kind of have a problem with that because I'm like, as me being a Street Fighter fan, I'm like, I feel like a lot of these game companies are just taking advantage of people now, because that's ridiculous. I mean, let's just say even $60, honestly, for the game was a waste to me, even if I just bought the game, because the game was not complete. The game can be completed within a couple of minutes because they gave you a storyline for each fighter, which there wasn't that many fighters. So, not happy at all. So now I have to go back and pay, I believe it's like $21 for like four or five fighters and some wardrobes. So basically, I'm going to spend like, $121 for this game so far. And I don't think they're even done releasing fighters. Let me know if you guys know or not, will they be done. But yeah, so $121, that's, like I said, that's not to say if they're going to bring out any more. So I didn't like how they did this at all with this game. And honestly, I didn't like the way the game played. It's okay. To me, it's not the best. I'd rather play King of Fighter. Like I said, I'm a Street Fighter fan, so, you know, it's just, I don't know, man. I don't like how some of these game companies are doing us. You know what I'm saying? How we go out, we buy their product, and they give us a half-ass game, and it's not even complete, and then they want us to pay extra money for something that we've been waiting for a very long time. So, guys, let me know what you think about that. Let me know how you feel about how Capcom or a lot of these other game companies are doing, bringing out half-ass games, because I can name so many other games that had came out that were not complete. Mafia 3, the game came out, amazing game. I talked about it before. Great storyline. The game got a bit repetitive, but now they're just now barely bringing out DLC. And I like how they're making it free. I like how 2K has made all of the DLC for Mafia 3 for free, because they realize, like, hey, we brought this game out too early. It was not complete. So they're rewarding people. And I know it's like a DLC for like, I have it right there. It's like DLC for like racing, and you can modify cars and stuff like that. Yeah, it's a little something, but it's the thought that counts. At least they know, like, hey, we screwed up. Let's just give them something. So I like the fact that they even did that for people who purchased the game. I think that's them recognizing their mistake and trying to work on it. So, yeah, again, guys, let me know what you think about the Capcom Street Fighter situation. So I'm just going to go on an overview of what I have here. Okay, there it is. And again, guys, if you're not following me on Instagram, my video game page is at King Mike D Games. That's at KINGMIKED. SGAMES. So yeah, hit me up. That's at KINGMIKEDGAMES. And Facebook, King Mike D Games. Just go in the search bar, search me, look for me. If you guys want to see anything else, let me know, and I'd be happy to go over it for you guys. So yeah, hit me up, let me know what's going on with you guys. The giveaway is coming soon. I will come with the details in my next video, and I will let you guys know what's going on with that. You guys have a good rest of the day. Well, actually, night. Happy New Year. New Year's is coming up. Be safe, everyone. Peace out.